The episode that you're about to see is an account of the tragedy which befell a poster artist, in particular, Tim Johnson. It's all the more tragic that he wasn't very young and takes too long to make new poster episodes. He could not have expected, nor would have wished, to see much of the mad and the macabre that he was to see that day. For him, an idyllic July afternoon became a nightmare. The events of that day were to lead to the discovery of one of the most bizarre poster compositions in the annals of misunderstood photography, the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Welcome back to Misunderstood Photography. I know that I've been gone for a little while, but I've been busy, and I am back with a really exciting poster for me. I am a big fan of classic horror. I love horror in general, but my sweet spot is 70s, 80s, and some 90s horror movies. I, today, am going to tackle one of my favorite horror movies from 1974, Tobe Hooper's classic, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Now, in regards to the original poster that was produced, it did its job. It was exactly what it was supposed to be. It had Leatherface and Sally, and it had a bunch of call-outs, and it did what it was supposed to do. It was pretty simple yet effective. But what I would like to do is a poster with the complete cast. So keeping it looking like it was cut from the same cloth, so to speak, as that original poster, so keeping the same style, but adding the extra cast, almost like, you know, you got the Texas Chainsaw Massacre one sheet, A, this would be B, and I see it in my head, the composition I could see being relatively simple to pull off, but trying to keep that same style and aesthetic is what's going to be hard. So I'm super excited to get into this today. So with that being said, take my hand on this artistic journey, and together we will jump into Photoshop.
Top news story, an informant led officers of the Muerto County Sheriff's Department to a cemetery just outside the small rural Texas community of Newt early this morning. Officers there discovered what appeared to be a grisly work of art, the remains of a badly decomposed body wired to a large monument. A second body was found in a ditch near the perimeter of the cemetery. Subsequent investigation has revealed at least a dozen empty crypts, and it's feared more will turn up as the probe continues. Deputies report that in some instances, only parts of a corpse had been removed. The head, or in some cases, the extremities removed, the remainder of the corpse left intact. Evidence indicates the robberies have occurred over a period of time. Sheriff Jesus Maldonado refused to give details in the Ghoulish case and said only that he did have strong evidence linking the crime to elements outside the state. Area residents have reportedly converged on the cemetery, fearing the remains of relatives have been removed. No suspects are in custody as the investigation at the scene continues. Refinery near the Texas-Louisiana. Three storage units exploded into flames.
Ha ha ha!
And here we are. And I am really pleased with myself. I'm really happy that I was able to keep that same aesthetic as the original poster, but add the composition of the complete cast. I kept the same call-outs, and I'm really happy with the end result. Believe it or not, the hardest thing for me to do in this whole poster was finding the exact font that they used on the original. I Googled for hours, and I found it. I found all of them, and I recreated the size and font style as the original poster. The composition was easy. I found so many great images of the cast that I wanted to use that I actually had a problem trying to pick ones over the other. But at the end of the day, I'm really happy with everything about this poster. This poster also doubles as a late birthday present to my dear friend Adam. His movie is the 74, the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Like Halloween is for me, Texas Chainsaw is for Adam, and this is Adam's late birthday present, and I hope you like it. So I'm super jazzed how this one turned out. If you're super jazzed, make sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, tick the notification bell to let you know when I'm doing new posters, and please, please, please leave all of your comments down below. Let me know what you thought of this video. Let me know what you thought of this poster. And if you have any ideas for other posters, other horror movies maybe, please leave them down below. Thank you so much for joining me on this artistic journey this evening. And until next time, have a good night.